praise the Lord. I am so glad to be back. This is London, where prayer is the key and faith unlocks the door. And Irene, are you on the line? Hello?
Hi, London.
Hi, how are you?
I'm great. I'm so glad.
Okay, hold on 1 second. Will you? I just wanted to make sure that you were there. We're glad to be back, and I want to thank staff, Mr. Watkins, and everybody making this possible, because I'm really supposed to be on next week. So praise God, I'm here. And our program is about prayer, faith, trusting the Lord. This inspirational inspiration about how we can live our life and how we can be successful, how we can be blessed, and how that the Lord will protect us from the adversary and the things that we go through in life, that, you know, if we have God in our life, that we are going to be all right. Part of our topic today that came to my mind was, who are we serving? What are we religious at? What spirit are we giving ourselves to? But we're going to get back to that right now because we have Miss Irene on the line. And I want to say hi to anybody that may be tuning in online, family, friends, or anybody that's watching television today. Miss Irene has something coming up, as a matter of fact, this Saturday, and I'd like her to talk about it. Hi, Irene.
Hi, everybody. Thank you, London, again, for allowing me to share this event. Black Panther, Black Panther's been raised for this past week. But on the 9th, we're going to be having a special Black Panther Free Family Movie Day. And that's going to be 10:30 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. at the Floor Performing Arts Center in Dearborn, Michigan. So we're going to have the movie. Then we're going to talk a little bit about our TV programs and how you guys can be a part. I know that London has some youth programming that she's working on. We want everybody in the community to come out and participate, enjoy the movie, and find out how they can be on TV. I also want to give a big shout-out to Little C, that's representing her company, Soon Adventures. She's going to have some fun merchandise, and we're also going to have snacks as well. Costumes are welcome. You can model your look. So it's going to be a great day of fun. If anyone wants to come out and join us this Saturday, starting at 10:30 a.m., you can give us a call for information at 313-681-1521. Again, that's 313-681-1521, and it's totally free, guys. So give us a call. We'd like to see you on Saturday.
Well, thank you so much, Miss Irene. If you'd like to stay on the line, you're welcome to. If you want to hang up, just let me know what you want to do.
I'd like to stay on the line with you.
Great. Okay. Thank you so much. We're waiting for our announcer to come as well. I'm not sure if she's here yet or not. But anyway, the program goes on. The topic I want to get into today, because I kind of got into this conversation a little bit early. Sometimes we want to control what happens in our life. And instead of some of us going to God and asking God to protect us, to keep us, to lead us, to guide us, we want a quick fix. And so some of us turn into some other types of sources. We lend our spirits not over to the Holy Spirit, not over to God, but to other spirits. So we got to be very careful. We need to be very careful how we do that. Some of the reasons are we want to be successful, or we love somebody and we really want that somebody, or we may have a little hatred going on and we hate somebody. Or you want to feel like, well, look, I'm going to control that. I don't want that person to be prosperous because I have an envious spirit. Or it could be love, hate, or I just want what I want and I want it now. And the Bible says if we give ourselves over unto the Lord, he said, whatever we shall ask for in the name of Jesus, that we will receive it. It's very important. Every now and then, the Lord will have me talk about this topic. It takes us far into, people may not even realize, when you try to start to become, to control the situation, you're delving into what is called witchcraft, which has been out for ages and ages, back in the Bible days, all the way to this present time. Many people feel that, oh, that's just, that can be around me, but, it could be the person next door, the person upstairs, it could be in the family. it could be somebody that you don't even know or somebody that you work with. It is very prevalent. People do different things for different reasons. And so we're bringing this topic up because God wants us to give our lives and ourselves over to Him. And once we start to control things and we have that stubborn spirit, the Bible says it is as witchcraft. I'm going to come up with some scriptures for you. Because, you know, sometimes we want it so bad, we got to go talk to somebody about it. Why not pray? The title of this show is Prayer is the Key and Faith Unlocks the Door. You got to have faith. You got to have prayer. And remove yourself and your mind. We got to remove ourselves from the situation. God has almighty power. He has so much power that He makes this world go around. He has so much power that if He wants to shut it down, He will. God allows things to happen. And so a lot of times we get fixed on, I did this, I can do this. And mind you, there are other spirits that we can tap into that will, you think, can cause things to happen. And it does, but it's a very bad backlash. There's a very bad effect behind that. And what you do returns to you. So that's where the prayer comes in. When we're in a hurry to try to get things done, when we are have anxiety, when we love this situation, some people just love a person so much. And, you know, I'm going to be truthful with you. I found this in my family. And I was going, like, what is going on here? People want people. People love people. So they do what they can do to get them. And they turn to sources that are not of God, including witchcraft. And so, you know, we ask you to beware, but we also want you to... We reckon talk about this because many times people don't talk about it. They don't talk about it. And it stems from the family, on the job. People want to get their business going. They do it on their business. The people do it in church. Now, it's getting deep now. Some people go, well, why you got to bring a church into this? Because things do happen everywhere. And it's about control. It's about making things work for you. It's about wanting. It's about gaining. It's about greed. It's about, sometimes it's about deep love. Sometimes it's about deep hate. Sometimes it's about jealousy. Sometimes it's about envious, being envy. But we're here to tell you that if you talk to the Lord about it, whatever you need, God's got it. Whatever you want, even, He said He'll give you the desires of your heart, God's got it. God says if you come to Him, He will allow you to have the power of the Holy Spirit within you to help you to do what you have to do. In Jesus' name. God will help you fight the enemy. Sometimes it could be something about an enemy. I'm going to read some scriptures to you because people are like, okay, what is she talking about? We know this is true, but we need to talk about it because, you know, it could be somebody very close to you that feels they want to do that. You might even think you might feel like doing something. This situation is not being handled. It's frustrating me, and I want what I want. We're going to get right back to this in about 1 minute, and we're going to ask Miss Irene to horn in, and then my announcer is here. She's here to make some announcements, and so he's going to take us off the set. We'll be right back. Remember, keep your hands in God's hands. Keep prayer alive. Keep faith alive, and rebuke the devil in Jesus' name. We'll be right back. Subject, and then we'll be able to do our announcement shortly. Is Irene still there?
Yes, I'm here.
Is there anything that you would like to say as we continue this conversation?
I'm just going to say you make it some very powerful points, and we need to be aware of some of the means that other people might go through to get what they want. You might not have that in your mind at all, but you need to be aware of what's around you. And it can be tempting to try to take care of things ourselves because I can say I can be pretty impatient and I want to get something done the way I want it done right now. So we have to rely on God for that. And some people are scared because they'll get what they want by any means. Like, I'll go as far as I can go, and then I'll stop. And I really just try to rely on God. But some people will go beyond that just to get what they want. Some things that you may not even think you think that anybody would think or do. So that's pretty scary.
Yeah, and but it's true. You know, they show it in the movies or whatever. I'm going to read the scripture to you. It's in the Bible. When I first, when I was a lot younger, teenager, I was reading the Bible. My father was a bishop, so, you know, he used to tell me about things to be careful about. So I grew up with knowledge of things that maybe a lot of people didn't know. And then the Lord has also given me a gift to be able to see these things. And so I'm going, what is that? You know, so that's when I was a child up until this present time. And you talk to people, and people, man, there's people that will talk to you and say, you know, I want to talk to you about this, but people think I'm crazy. You know, then they'll start telling me what's going on. I say, no, you're not crazy. Because it says it in scripture. You know, I remember when I was a little girl and I was watching some movie, and the witch was on there and scared me half to death, but I thought it was a fantasy. Oh, that's just not, oh, that's not real. And, you know, I was reading the Bible one day, and where it said, do not practice witchcraft. And how, witchcraft is the causes of, brings a curse upon you and the generations thereof. And I'm like, witchcraft is real? So I became really aware of that at a very young age. But Deuteronomy 18, let me tell you why. Some people say there's good witchcraft, there's black witchcraft, there's white witchcraft. In God's sight, no witchcraft is good. Okay? None. It says in Deuteronomy 18, it says, when thou art coming to the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee, thou shalt not learn to do the abominations of those nations. It is abomination. There shall not be found among you anyone that maketh his son or his daughter pass through the fire. We're going to take it through fire. That uses divination, an observer of the times, or a enchanter, or a witch, or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or necromancy. For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord. And because of these abominations, the Lord thy God does drive them out from before thee. There's so many scriptures in the Bible that speaks about that. It says in Leviticus 20:6, and the soul that turn after such as familiar spirits and after wizards to go whoring after them, I will even set my face against that soul and will cut him off among his, from among his people. So we can get deeper than this some days, but it's just something that God put in me. Occasionally God will say, you know, you need to talk about that. Because I see it frequently. I see it frequently. And sometimes you wonder what's going on with you in your life, and you don't know that what is amongst you, what someone may be doing, working with those spirits. So this is a time that you need to bring yourself to Christ Jesus, because God can block it, he can rebuke it, he can stop it, and he can cover you from whatever's going on. For things you don't know, having Christ in your life will protect you from these things. And it's just a reality. It's not a joke. And it's not something to be laughed at. But it's a true thing. So if you wonder why things are spinning out of control, or why this keeps happening, that keeps happening, it's more than one way that it can cause these curses. Because if, like the scripture says, if you attend to these things, it will curse you and the people thereafter, your generations thereafter, because you turn away from God and you turn to these familiar spirits, witchcraft, wizards, necromancy, stargazers, observers of the times. You know, the world acts like this is fine. This is not. Sidekicks, no, that is not of God. If God sends you into a place where someone is a true prophet, not a fake prophet, a true prophet, someone that can discern the spirit of God, he sends them to your life. If you stay in the vein of the Lord, God will lead and guide you in that. But, you know, we have to be very careful of playing around. Some people play around with the spirits. You know, they teach these classes even at major universities. They teach witchcraft. It has become a religion, you know. So we just want you to understand, please turn yourself over unto the Lord. And this may be an extended conversation. Our time, we came on late. I think the show comes on after, so we will be getting off shortly. But this is Prayer is a Key of Faith Unlocks the Door. Give yourself to the Lord. Pray. Spiritual warfare. You know, the Bible says pray and have faith, and then he says you can move that mountain, but by moving that mountain comes prayer and fasting. Read the Bible. Pray. Give your special attention over to the Lord so he can give his special attention to you. And God can work in you, and he can bless you to even discern things and be able to pray about them even beforehand. We got to pray, folks. This is getting up every day, running in a fast, speedy way, not giving God any time. No, we need to pray. And he said pray without ceasing. That means if I pray all day, it's hey. You know, so we need to give God time to pray for things we don't know is happening. For us of us, that God covers us. You know, but it pays to be a child of God because he will take care of you. He will protect you and yours. It's not going to say things are going to come upon you, but God will take care of you. He will stop things from happening. He will prevent things, intervention. And if something does, and it doesn't mean, oh, I'm not going to get sick. No, it doesn't mean that. Because God is a healer as well. But it doesn't mean, he says, a ray is on the just as well as the unjust. But these supernatural spirits that are out there that people toy with and play with to get what they want. That's what they do. But in the end, you're going to pay. They pay before the end. And then you bring a curse upon you and there in the generation thereafter just because you turn to these spirits and not of God. Those spirits are not of God. There's only one God. There's only one God. And there's only one adversary, which is Satan. Now, in between, there's no in between. So if you're not giving God your attention, then you're giving the devil your attention. If you're leaning to your own understanding, then you are not leaning to God, you're leaning to Satan. So we want you to do that because life will be a lot better. God will give you what you need. He'll broaden your territory. God will protect you and keep you all seen, unseen, hurt, harm, and danger. This is London. I'm back. We were off doing some other projects, and God let me come back. We're here to tell the truth. So that you can break down those strongholds. So life will change. So you can be blessed. Yes. Irene, I thank you for being there. Right now, we're going to have Miss Renee give some announcements of things that's coming up.
Wow, that is so true. Hi, my name is Renee, and I'm standing there for Miss Betsy Sproul, our project announcer. We have a few announcements to make. The first announcement, we would like for you to join London's Trade Enrichments. We're having a Black Panther movie, Family Day. It's free. Now, this is Saturday at 10:30 a.m. at the Ford Performing Arts Center. For more information, please call 248-701-0885 and 313-681-1521. Or 419-245-4979. This event is free. And you can also please wear your favorite costume and be seen on cable television. That would be quite fun. Our second announcement, and also donations are always accepted. Join ADI Actors and Entertainment Club and Over the Top Models Club. Act in films, stage plays, television, YouTube. Please call 419-245-4979 or 248-701-0885. Our third announcement. Be a part of London's Biblical Coffee Fix, and that's P-H-I-X, every third Thursday at Always Brewing. Talk about the Bible and life. And this is from 5 to 7 p.m. It will be filmed for YouTube and television. Please call 248-701-0885 or 419-245-4979. Be a part of our broadcast team. Dial 248-701-0885 and 419-245-4979. And that's to be a part of London's broadcast team. And our last announcement, tune in into Late Night with London on WMKM 1440 Friday at midnight and WCVG in Cincinnati Friday at 11:30 p.m. Bye.
Well, thank you so much, Renee, for professionally doing this. I'm going to wrap it up. Ms. Irene, thank you for staying with us. You want to say goodbye?
Thank you for asking me. Goodbye, everyone. Congratulations.
Thank you, WHPR, Mr. Watkins. Thank you, darling. Thank you, Tim and Mayor. Thank you, Ms. Renee, and thank God for everything. You guys be safe out there. Remember to pray. Remember to keep the faith. Prayer is the key, and faith unlocks the door. Take it serious, as God's word is true. He will cover you from the storm. He'll take you through some places where you can go around the storm, and he won't even touch you. God is an awesome God, and he can do whatever you need and what your heart desires. That is what the word says. So turn away from the wicked ways. Turn away from self. Turn away from other spirits that is not of God. And God bless you. Prayer is the key. Faith unlocks the door. God bless you. See you next time.